Namaskaram students.
Today we are going to learn about bills of exchange, an interesting chapter that we are going to discuss now. That is how, why we are writing the bill of exchange. What does mean the bill of exchange? See, to increase the sales, what we have to do? We have to sell the product in credit, isn't it? So then only our product will reach more person, and also we can get the money, isn't it? Our sales will not be spoiled. Whatever the stock will go outside. See, for example, X sold goods to Y now. Y is telling that, see, now it is not possible for me to pay the money. See, X sold goods worth rupees 50,000 rupees. So 50,000 rupees I am not having now. At present I am not having 50,000 rupees. I will pay you after 2 months or 3 months. So for that, what the X will think? Anyhow, after 3 months we will receive the money. So we must sell the product. We must cover the customer. We should keep up the customer. By giving credit facilities, more customer will come, because we can, if we go to that shop means we can get in credit. So credit facility will increase the sales. So for that, X is also accepting. It's okay. You can give after 2 months or 3 months. For that, what we need? We need evidence. Isn't it? After 2 months or 3 months, if we not scored evidence, what we do? It is too suffering, isn't it? So after 3 months and after 2 months, he will give the money. For example, so for that, X will write the bill of exchange. He will write a bill and hand over to Y. What is that one? That is, Y is not paying the amount immediately. So after 2 or 3 months, 3 months after, pay to me. So that, what are all the amounts? 50,000 only for value received. So he will write in a stamped paper. That is called bills of exchange. As far as X is concerned, that is seller is concerned, that is the goods receivable. So who is it? He is selling the goods. He is a buyer, is a debtor for him. As far as he is a creditor, isn't it? So that is called bills receivable. As far as Y is concerned, that is a bills payable. Have you found the clear, girls? Now, see, this is period of 60 to 90 days. And also, they will give 3 days grace period. Everything let us see. So, this is the specimen. There are, this is the specimen of bill of exchange. Now, let us see about the specimen of bill of exchange. See, are you seeing the specimen of bill of exchange? That is, it should be in a stamped paper we have to write. That is, here we have to write the address, all the address of who is receiving the goods. Rupees 10,000 or 15,000, as we wish how much amount they are giving. 3 months after, pay to me or to pay my order, the sum of rupee 10,000 rupees. Or whatever amount the buyer is getting, that amount we should write in a stamped paper. It should be revenue stamp. So who is writing the bill? To Jyoti Kumar, to Jyoti Kumar. So there are 3 parties are involving. Let us see about, see who is the drawer, who is the drawee, who is the payee. In this bill of exchange, 3 parties are involving. So here we are going to write the buyer address, here seller address. Have you clear, girls? Now the buyer name is Ramesh Babu. Now let us see the, like this they are preparing the bill. Now that in accounting terms we call it as a drawing a bill. Preparing a bill is called as a drawing a bill. How to say drawing? This is not the meaning that drawing. Preparing a bill in accounting terms we call it as a drawing a bill. Now, who are all the parties and what is the features of bill of exchange? Let us see. I have told you the three parties are involved in the bill of exchange, and that drawer, drawee, payee, isn't it? So the person who prepares the bill is called drawer. The person who prepares the bill is called drawer. And then the person who makes the payment or who accepts to make the payment is called drawee. Here in this case, buyer, FY is a drawee, debtor. Here X is a creditor, isn't it? Then payee, who receives the payment? Payee may be a third party or may be a drawer. Drawer and payee may be both are same. Here in this, according to this specimen, Jyoti Kumar is a drawer and also payee, because Jyoti Kumar is drawing a bill to Ramesh Babu. Have you clear this? Here in this above specimen, drawer and payee is drawer. Here, listen here. Drawer and payee. Drawer and payee. That is Ramesh Babu. Ramesh Babu is writing a bill, isn't it? So Jyoti Kumar is accepting the bill. He is called drawee. Who is accepting the bill? Who has made the payment? How they will make the payment? After receiving the bill from the Ramesh Babu, Jyoti Kumar see the bill of all the amount and pay month, everything is correct or not. And then on the stamp, they will write accepted. Have you clear this? That is called bills of exchange. In this bills of exchange, there are some certain features of there. What are the features? And also, what is the due date of calculated due date and days of grace? And then this bill of exchange is covered in Act, Negotiable Instrument Act. In as per according to this Act, about this Act, we are going to learn elaborately in the standard. Just you should know what is a negotiable instrument act. The word negotiable means transferable. We can transfer this bill to the another party if we need money. See, 3 months we are giving credit, isn't it? So this bill can be transferred to another person. That is, if we need money, this bill we can hand over to the bank and we can get the amount. So that we are going to see later. What is endorsement? What is discounting? What is the retailing of bill? Everything we are going to learn in detail. Now let us see what is the negotiable instrument. What is negotiable instrument? According to Negotiable Instrument Act 1881, that what says, what is bill of exchange? It is an instrument. So what is this? It is an instrument, and then it is a containing written instrument is writing containing an unconditional order. Unconditional order means we can transfer to any other person. That is called unconditional order. Then it is signed by the maker. It is signed by the maker means who is accepting. Signed by the maker, who is preparing the bill. That is called signed by the maker. And directing a certain person to pay a certain sum of money. Here Jyoti Kumar is, Ramesh Babu is directing Jyoti Kumar to pay certain sum of money. So that is called directing a certain person to pay certain sum of money. And only to or to the order of certain person or to the bearer of the instrument. See, the word bearer means who is having this bill, who is bringing this bill. The, for that person, we have to give the amount which is prescribed in the bill. That is called bearer of the bill. Bearer check means who is bringing the check. That particular person, we have to give whatever amount in the check leaf. Have you clear this? Now let us see about what are the features of bill of exchange. It contains some features. What are they? That is, it is a written document. It is a document, because why we are telling this as a document? After 3 months, sales book, purchases book we are seeing, isn't it? So all the credit sales, everything will come under. See, for example, all the sales, all the credit sales will come under bills receivable. All the credit sales will come under bills receivable. All the credit purchase, all the credit purchase will come under bills payable. Have you heard this? Wherever we are purchasing, that particular person we have to pay. Wherever we are selling, that particular person, the other person will have to pay to us. Have you clear? Now let us move on to features of bill of exchange. Now, already I have told you features of bills of exchange. See, that is, we can analyze from the definition itself. I have told you the definition, isn't it? What are all the definitions? In the definition, what I said, it is an instrument containing an unconditional order. So from that definition we can know it is a written document, and it is an unconditional order. We can change to another person. It will move on. So there is no restrictions in the bill of exchange. An order to pay sum of money. So it is an order to pay a certain sum of money. So X want to pay a certain sum of money to Y. So that is order containing in that bill of exchange. And also it is signed by the drawer. Who is preparing the bill is called a drawer. That should be signed by the drawer. Already in the specimen we have seen, here in this case of drawer, as far as the specimen is concerned, drawer is a Ramesh Babu. So drawer and payee are same. Maybe third party will come. Then stamp paper, it should be written in the stamp paper only, unless and until it is not valid. It is not considered as a bill of exchange. It should be in a stamp paper. So it bears stamps. Otherwise, in a paper, in corner, we should stamp, affix the revenue stamp. On the revenue stamp only, both the drawer and the drawee must put sign. And also it is accepted. It is to be accepted by the acceptor. Acceptor who? Who is buying the product? He is called as an acceptor. And then the amount of bill is paid to a drawer or NRC. The amount of bill is paid to drawer or NRC. Whatever the amount here, the Y want to pay to X, isn't it? That should be specified in the specimen. So now next let us move on to the, just let us recall what is the introduction of bill of exchange. Few points let us recall. See what, why we are preparing the bill of exchange to increase the sales. What we will do? We have to sell the goods in the credit, isn't it? Sell the goods on credit to this customer. If sales is made on credit, cash will not be received immediately. We can't receive the cash immediately. The seller may draw a bill on the customer for the amount due from him. So the seller may draw a bill on the customer, whatever the amount due from him. Then if a customer accept it, so the customer, he is a customer. So the customer accept it, the seller can get the same discounted with the bank and get the cash immediately. So he will receive the bills receivable. What he will do? How he is going to get the discount from the bank? Let us see now. Now let us know about the discounting of bill. See, X sold goods to Y, isn't it? How much worth of goods? 50,000 worth of goods. See, for that, X is not in a position to settle the amount cash immediately. He is not giving the cash immediately, isn't it? So that what he is going to receive from, X is going to prepare a bill of exchange. So Y is also accepting the bill of exchange. So X is receiving the bill from the y. That is called bills receivable. See, x want to receive 50,000 from y. So as far as y is x is concerned, that is bills receivable. As far as y is concerned, that is bills payable. So what he will do? Promise after 3 months. For that 2 months or 3 months, bill of exchange period is 150 days. You can see 60 days or 90 days. The bill due date, you can settle the amount for 60 days or 90 days. So when he will pay the amount after 60 days or after 90 days, you can take up to 90 days. What he will need X want to do the business, isn't it? So within 3 months, for his working capital will spoil. He want to do the day-to-day operations. Day-to-day operations, from which one he is going to get the capital? Whatever they are selling, the same amount want to be in the rotation of the business today. What he will do? That same bill, X will take to the bank and surrender. Give the bill to the bank. The bank will give discount the bill and bank will give 80% or 90% of the amount to the X. Immediately the bank will hand over the amount to X. So for example, 50,000 worth of bill the X is producing to bank. So bank immediately hand over 49,000 rupees to X. 1,000 rupees they will take it as a processing charges. That is the discounting of bill. So now let us move on to how to calculate the due date and days of pay. For example, date of bill. See, I sold the goods. The buyer who is receiving the goods from me, they promised to pay on 1st March, isn't it? The date of bill I have prepared on 1st March. They asked the time for me, period of 2 months. After 60 days only, they are going to hand over the money to me. So, 2 months, all the bill, we must give days of grace. 3 days is the days of grace. 3 days we should give. It is mandatory. We must give 3 days time, because that is a breathing period for him. So, 3 days we should give days of grace. That day we call it as a days of grace. 2 months and 3 days. So, which day? 1st March we have prepared the bill, isn't it? So, March, 1st March, April, 1st April, then 1st May, 2 months over, isn't it? So, after 2 months, what we have to calculate? 3 days, days of grace. So, April 1, April, May 1, May 2, May 3, 3 days fully have to give. On 4th May, he must give the amount. That is called bill of days of grace, due date and days of grace, how to settle the amount. Then 12th July we are preparing the, see, so many persons we are selling the goods to credit. We can take for example, X I have prepared 1st March, then Y I have prepared 12th July, 1st October I have prepared Z. So many credit sales I have made. So for him, X is telling after 2 months only I will give the amount. So when I have received the money from X, 4th May. Then Y is telling after 1 month I will pay the money. So 1 month and 3 days grace period, that is uniformly I have to give for all the credit sales. So when July 12th, isn't it? So August 12th, 3 days grace days. August 15th is the public holiday. Since it is a public holiday, the preceding day we have to settle the amount. Have you heard clear, girls? So 14th August, that bill should be settled down. Then 1st October I am preparing the bill for Z. He is telling that 30 days I need time. So 30 days plus 3 days grace. So when I have to receive the money from X? On 3rd November. So 1st October, then November 31st November, and then what is the 1st October? 30 days, isn't it? 30 days means October 30. October 31, November 1, November 2, over, isn't it? So, November 3rd, I have received money from Z. for each and every person we have seen, isn't it? So maturity of bill, it will come under the any emergency holiday. Emergency holiday means, see, for example, now the emergency holiday, they have declared lockdown period and they have declared here any strike or anything will come. At that time, we have to settle the amount in a pre-succeeding day. The payment of bill will be the succeeding day. That is called maturity of bill. So when we have to settle the amount for maturity of bill, if maturity day falls on emergency holiday, succeeding day will be the due day. Succeeding day means, see, for example, maturity date will be on 14th December. Then which day will be the succeeding day? The next day, 15th December, we have to settle down. That is called maturity of bill, the payment of bill. Let us move on to endorsement, discounting, retirement of bill and how to renewal the bill. What is discerner? Let us see later. Now, what is mean by endorsement? See, endorsement means transferring to others. We are signing on the face of the bill of exchange, or else in the backside of the bill of exchange, we are signing and hand over to other person. So who is endorsing? They is called endorser. To whom the bill is endorsed, that is called endorsee. So the endorsee is a person is entitled to, the endorsee is entitled to collect the money. He is called endorsee. So what is endorsement? Transferring the bill of exchange to others. So endorsement means signing on the face or back of a bill for the purpose of transferring the title. Transferring the title of bill of exchange means, if I want to give 1000 rupees to X or Z, means the same 1000 rupees worth of bill of exchange, I can put sign on backside of the bill of exchange. I can transfer to the concerned X or Y, some other person. That is called endorsement. Then discounting. Already we have seen, the holder of a bill, if he is in need of money, he must hand over the bill of exchange, bill receivable to bank, and he can encash the amount. 80-90% of the amount he can encash from the bank, and the bank will get the, bank will collect the processing charges, as we call it as a discount of discounting the bill. Then retirement of bill, the actually the payment period, the period of a payment will going to mature. So before the maturity period, if you meet the bill, see, for example, the maturity period will be on November 1. Immediately September 30th we meet out the bill, we can settle the bill, means that is called retirement of bill. The holder will give the concession. How the trade discount will happen, isn't it? So how, why they are giving the trade discount? We are purchasing bulk. That is also one of the advantages. And also we are giving the cash discount, we can see. Cash discount, we are giving the cash immediately. See, we promise to pay on, for example, you can take December 2. Today itself I am having money. November 30th I am settling the amount to the concerned person. So in that case, like the same way, if I want to meet the bill, the actual maturity period of the bill is December 2. You can take for example. November 30th itself I can meet out the bill, means the holder, the bill holder will give concession to me. That concession we call it as a revenge. Then come to renewal of bill. Renewal of bill means, we know the person who wants to meet the bill, the person, that concerned person can know very well, he is not in a position to meet the bill. In that case, he can hand over the bill to the drawer and he can cancel the bill. Instead of that, he can get the new bill. When, while he is getting the new bill, he can get another date. See, some 2 months or 3 months extension period he can get. So, while in case of he is not in a position to, the acceptor is not in a position to meet out the bill, he can get the new bill. That is called renewal of bill. For example, December 2, I have to pay the amount to Jyoti Kumar. You can take for example. On that particular day, I was not paid that particular amount to Jyoti Kumar. Means what will happen? That is called dishonor of bill. When the bill was presented, at that time, non-payment of the bill is called dishonor of bill. Now let us move on to what is the bills receivable book? What is meant by bills payable book? How to calculate the bills receivable and how to calculate bills payable? What is journal proper? Let us see in the next video. This is all about bill of exchange.